Hey guys, after a ton of requests, we're finally taking on some Spider-Man projects. Now, Spider-Man's always been one of my favorite heroes, and if you're watching this video, probably one of yours too. One of the things I really like about Spider-Man is he's almost feasible. It's within the realm of possibility that someone could become Spider-Man. Okay, well, maybe not the crazy strength, but the ability to climb walls, swing from webs, and the crazy agility, that's all possible. I mean, there are rock climbers out there who can put even cartoon Spider-Man to shame and beat him in a race. And cartoon Spider-Man, he doesn't even have to follow the basic laws of physics or gravity. Feet per second, that's faster than some people jog.
Let's see if I can even crawl that fast.
Foreseeably, if you trained really hard, you could actually get to the fitness level of Spider-Man. I mean, minus the strength of 10 men, obviously. And then, if you couple above average fitness ability with the right technology, you could become Spider-Man. Heck, I've already made electromagnetic climbers, which allow me to climb metal walls. So the question is, what other Spider-Man technology could we make? And what technology already exists?
Activating reconnaissance drone.
The cool thing is, a drone like this is actually possible. In fact, we got a Dji Spark from TomTop, and while it's a bit bigger than this drone, it's almost as functional.
Whoa.
Has that been there this whole time? That's awesome.
Proceed to southwest window.
There's also an official toy version of the Spider-Man drone, so...
What if we could actually make a docking system so it can actually attach to the Spider-Man costume and fly off, just like in the movie? What do you guys think? Should we do it? Let us know in the comments below. So, besides the drone, what other Spider-Man technology could be made real? Now, what if you wanted to be a bad guy? Vultures Wingsuit is actually possible. It's basically a giant drone. And the way our EDF design for the Flying Like Iron Man project is going, we might be flying like Vulture instead. Did you know there are dozens and dozens, maybe even hundreds of YouTube channels dedicated to trying to bring Spider-Man technology to life? It's awesome. Most of the channels are trying to figure out how to make real-life web fluid. After all, that is Peter Parker's claim to fame, becoming Spider-Man. Unfortunately, while I think web fluid might actually be possible, it's pretty unlikely someone's gonna make it at home. I feel like it's gonna be a university research lab that cracks the code. But I could be wrong. For argument's sake, let's say someone discovered web fluid. What if one of those channels I listed actually figured out how to make real working web fluid? Then what? No, seriously, then what? If you've made web fluid, you're gonna wanna swing from it. Do you know how hard it is to swing from one arm? Oh. Do you know how hard it is to do it without dislocating your shoulder? I'd show you, but my shoulder's still healing from being dislocated while testing Star-Lord's jetpack. Ah, God. Feels better now. Still very painful.
Jeez.
Ow. So let's say you did have the strength to swing from webs. Or, like Alan Pan shown in his Spider-Man project, a hidden body harness that can take the weight from your arm. Which, by the way, I think is kind of cheating using a harness. And besides, how are you going to fit that underneath a spandex Spider-Man costume? But seriously though, you should check out his series of videos on Spider-Man projects. He's making his own web slingers, and they look pretty awesome. Anyway, if you're capable of swinging without dislocating your shoulder, either by mutant strength or some kind of body harness, how are you going to actually grip onto the web? If it's only a few millimeters in diameter, I don't think even the strongest rock climber could hang onto this, let alone climb it. And let's be honest, having a hidden hook or carabiner, that's not gonna work either. And it's not very Spider-Man. How are you gonna swing and release with one of these? That's where I come in. I want to bring my engineering knowledge to the Spider-Man fandom. I want to figure out how we'd actually hang on to web ropes, and if that goes well, then develop web shooters. Enough talking about it. Let me show you what I made. So this is my little pet project that I've been playing around with on the weekends. Basically, I'm trying to make a compact mechanism that can go on your hand or wrist and allow you to have superhuman grip strength, allowing you to hold a Kevlar rope. Now, the design itself is actually pretty simple. I borrowed something from sailing. You see, on sailboats, there's actually something called a rope clevis, which pinches a rope in between it, and the harder you pull the rope, the tighter it grabs the rope. Unfortunately, they don't make them small enough for Kevlar line or strong enough, which means I've had to design my own. To do this, I used a combination of my CNC laser cutter and 3D printer to prototype the parts. My very first one I made out of acrylic because it's super quick to laser cut and the plastic's actually pretty strong. From there, the design continued to evolve. I started focusing on the ergonomics. I again used wood to shape it to my hand to figure out what approximate size I wanted it to be. From there, I created a 3D model and finished the actual mechanism, which works quite well. As you can see, I've also evolved the cam gear design throughout the process. I started with 3D printing the cams, and then I ended up using our Mark II 3D printer, which actually prints in carbon fiber, to actually reinforce the teeth of the gear, which I found necessary for this to work. And finally, we have revision 11, which works, but I'm not done with the design yet. Basically, you can slide the rope in between the gears, and then when you pull on it, it actually tightens. And go a bit higher. Damn it. As you can see, still need some work, but we're almost there. Are you still recording?
Yeah.
So one of the current issues with the design is because it is 3D printed, there is still some flex in the entire system. So as you can see, even though the gears mesh together like that, if you push really, really hard, you can actually get them to pop through, and that's what just happened. So in order to fix this, what we might end up having to do is actually machine the parts using our CNC mill. But there's still a few other things that I need to try fixing before we go that route. Man, that really stinks. As you can see, I have a bit of work ahead of me before I can get this prototype working properly, but we've made quite a bit of progress, and you're gonna wanna make sure you're subscribed. This is going to be a really cool project. My goal is to be able to climb a 3mm Kevlar rope all the way to the ceiling, and then swing from it too. Plus, we're working on a Spider-Man costume to go with it. My fingers hurt. I got a lot of skin on the index finger, and then I've got like a friction burn on the middle finger. Goodbye, fingerprint. You know Kevlar is super abrasive? It's like a friggin' saw blade.